Hello, and welcome to another episode of Matter Hacks, brought to you by Actionable Insights. My name is Seth Harrison, and today I want to talk about a brand new feature called How to Convert a 360 View to a 3D Scan. We've had talks in the past, part of the AI Matterport certified course, the difference between the 3D scan, capturing and stitching, aligning, and the 360 capture or 360 view, where it's not using the infrareds and it's just capturing forensic photography, and that you would use these 360 captures primarily outside when it's sunny and the 3D scan would have a hard time scanning, stitching, and aligning. But Matterport introduced a new feature recently of how to convert a 360 view to a 3D scan to fill out hard to capture spaces, but still have them stitch. Think like a pool area of an outdoor area that you're trying to scan. Now, for the purposes of this video and this demonstration, I am currently in California and staying at home. So I am doing all of this in my office and I have started a scan here. You'll see some iPad footage from me recording on my Capture app to perform this. But to walk through this here, you'll see, all right, I have the Matterport Pro 2 camera here. I have started capturing. Number 2 scan is over here in this area, specifically number 2. And then number 3 is over here by my front door of this of my office. And what I had done in the in actually performing these scans, I had closed all of the doors. Doors to the office, doors to my hallway and everything. And the goal was to simulate capturing a 360 view outside of a house and then placing it on the map and converting it to fill out that space. So I've actually not done it yet. It's my first time. Let's check this out. So I've already captured the 360 scan, the 360 view, and I'm going to hit this button in the bottom right here to bring it up. And in the top right, there is the place on map feature. And knowing that my number 1 360 view is right outside of the door where my 3 scan was here, right here, I'm going to move over and drop the one there. And it gives me the opportunity to rotate it. Now I know, you can see my dog there, that my dog would go here on this side, coming out of the office. And I'm going to leave it there. Now, I'm going to bring up the support article here so you can watch the steps as well as I do this. The first thing I did was actually go to the main app, and actually I'll go back out of this job, come here, in the settings in the top left, go to storage and firmware, and you can see that I have the 3D conversion switch on. Now that I am in there, I can go to the back to my scan here, 360 3D, click this, and the number 1 being the 360 view that I dropped in, and there's a new option on the bottom. It says convert to 3D, experimental. Let's experiment. I'm going to hit the convert to 3D here. You can see on the right side, it's executing 3D conversion. And it is aligning now as it is attempting to stitch. And it has no alignment because there were no scans previously. So this is a great limitation. I am going to pause the recording here, redo the scan with the doors open. But what we found out here is that if all those doors are closed and you're just taking one remote 360 capture outside of the house with nothing for it to stitch to, then it's going to have some problems and not be able to stitch. But I actually prepared multiple examples of this, so give me one moment and I'll be back with more. All right, and we're back. Thanks for that quick non-second break. I have here a new scan on my screen available for you. Same 1 and 2 starting points, but as you can kind of see in my hallway here behind me, I actually have performed my 360 view right outside the door. I had all my doors open, as you can see some splay here on the screen. As you can see, my doors were open. So I'm going to come here to the bottom right again, grab that 360 capture here, take a look around, looking good. Going to place on the map. I'm going to place it over here where my camera is right this very moment. And you can see it's actually automatically oriented towards the office correctly where it should be. I'm going to leave it there. And then when I come back and hit this one, I'm going to leave it there, press back. Come back and hit the one here. And I can now hit convert to 3D experimental. You'll see on the right side, it's going to attempt executing 3D conversion again. At the top, it is now aligning. And let's see how experimental we can get, baby. Boom! That's amazing. So it just took a 360 and was able to convert and fill out the space into a 3D environment and be able to stitch and align, filling out that hallway without capturing all the data in the way that it had to previously. That's a huge upgrade. I can see, at least in my particular here, when I zoom in here, you can see on the 3 side that there is a slight black area to the right of the 3, which could be a potential misalignment. Now, I can still see that the walls are still aligning well, but it just is showing me that it didn't capture enough data in that one particular section, and you would want to make sure that if you need that section to be potentially realigned, or more importantly, if I were to continue to go do scans down this hallway further up in the capture app, that black space would be filled out. But wow, this worked amazingly well. I'm very impressed. This has huge applications for all those tough areas that were historically difficult for you to stitch to, and you kept getting a problem saying one line can't stitch, no, not enough data. You can attempt to, instead of continuing hitting 3D scan, try to jump to a 360 view, capture that 360, which is going to work, then place it on the map and hit this convert to 3D button that's now available as long as you enable it in the settings. So check it out. This is exciting. This is a new Matter hack, a new Matterport technology technique that we can use in the claim settlement process. If you could, show us some support and love. Go ahead and like, share, subscribe to us on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn. We're even on Reddit. Hope this helps. Hope you guys have an opportunity to take advantage of this soon and fill out those spaces that you're trying to capture in really unique professional ways. In the meantime, I will see you soon. Thank you.